Welcome back guys. So in this video I will talk about the filter method which probably we have seen that in previous example, but here I have made a separate method altogether as a filter. So if you look at here, the first one which will give you the list of a string, right? I'm doing that array.addList. Here there are some empty data we have, which we can see that. So through filter, can we remove this? Yes, we can. So list of a stream, by now we know that the return type of when you call a stream on any list, the return type will be the stream of object. So the stream of what object? The object which we have in the list, which is nothing but a string. Then we say dot filter. When we say dot filter, filter basically, when we'll click on the filter, it takes predicate as an input. What it will take? It will take predicate as an input, and predicate has only one method called test method. So either I can write predicate outside. Let me write a predicate. So it's a functional interface. So let's say it is a string, input is a string, then predicate is equal to, I can write what data it is a string, and I can just write a dot is empty, right? So this predicate will just tell me how many empty data you have. So either I can write predicate outside, or I can write predicate inside the filter itself, right? So basically, whatever you write this lambda expressions, this is the implementations of your test method, which is available in the predicate. In predicate, it has a test method. So you are basically writing the implementations of test, right? Now, when you call like test dot count, so basically it will count all the stream of object which has empty as a data. So how many you have? Two. So this will give you two. Then you are saying that count the stream, filter it where it is data is not empty, and then count that. So this is going to be four. So let's run that, right? You can see that 2, 4, that is the output. Look at the second example. So here if you look at what I did is I have arrays.addList. Okay, we have few data, right? Here it's little bit different. What I'm trying to do that is I'm running a stream on my list, doing that dot filter. So I'm trying to do a filter on the length. So whatever string you have, right? So these are the string object one by one. The moment you'll call the stream internally, it will run a loop on your list. Okay, it will run the loop. So one by one, it will fetch the string data, and it will do dot length. So x dot dot length, if it is greater than 3, right, then count that. Like if the length of the string is greater than 3, count that. And when you call this count, you will get output as an count, right? So there are two things. If you don't want to count, let's say if you just want to do a filter and you want to data, so this also will give you the data. So you can write that new list. So basically it will give you all together a stream of a string, right? You can see that a stream of a string it will give you. On this you can call any method of the string, right? You can run a for each loop, you can do some other operations, it's up to you. But here I'm calling it count so that I can explain you the count return type is the long. So of course this will give you data 1, 2, 3, 4. It will give you 4 data because 4 string has length more than 3. Then a second filter. So filter, it will take predicate. So this is the predicate basically, right? So start with T, then count it, right? Let me write one predicate. Let me show you. Predicate, it will take a string as an argument. Predicate is equal to a string. And I am saying that if a dot starts with, let's say t, right, dot Okay, so predicates are just you can test the conditions. So this is your conditions. So this is your predicate. So either you can write the test implementations, right? So basically, when you write the predicate and whatever you write, this lambda expressions, it's a functions basically, which is nothing but implementations of this test method, guys. Clear? Now come back. So when you have this predicate, and when you do this, and when you do a count, so basically whatever start with t, a small t, you are counting it, right? Now similarly, another filter you have where you are doing that too low. So basically what output you should get here, right? You will get output as an zero, because there is a none of the data which is starting with a small t, okay? None of the data starting with a small t, all is starting with capital T. But here the same thing, x dot to lowercase. So first I'm changing to the lowercase. So all the string will get converted to the lowercase, and then start with a small t. So here I will get data, four data I will get, right? So let's run this. See 404, right? You can see that 404. So first print came from line number 26 in my Eclipse. So 26 count length greater than 3, yes, it is 4 string. Then 0, as I told you, there is no list which start with a small letter. But again, the last one, where when you change to the lowercase your string and then you check for start with, you will get output as an 4. So your output is the 404. So now we'll see that other example. So here if you see in this example, we have array dot as list, right? Again, we are running a filter, and this is my predicate. So my predicate, what it will do, so basically what happens when you do write x, right? So x, you know what it will do, this stream one by one, it will supply the integer data, it will supply the integer data to this x, like 20, 11, 28, 4 and 5, one by one it will come as this x. And then on that x, I'm doing that modulus if is equal to 0, right? If is equal to 0, then I am running a for each loop. So if you'll take till here, let's say if you'll take till here, and if you'll store into a variable new list, so this guy will give you a stream of integer, right? The integer is the data which you have stored into a list. So you have a stream of integer, you did a filter, and then you are running a for each loop. So you know that for each loop the input is a consumer, for each loop input is the consumer, so there is no return type, it will just process your data. So I'm doing the dot for each loop and then run this, okay? And then again, if not modulus 2 on the filter, then again run a for each loop. So it will give you odd and even by using this filter. So one first will give you all your even number, because you are doing that modulus 2 is equal to 0, line number 20 in my Eclipse, and then line number 25 in my Eclipse. You can see that here line number 25 we have, this is line number 25. So there we are doing that not modulus, so we'll get output as an 11 and 5, right? With this we are done with filter. Let me give you one more example of filter, guys, which is very simple one. So if you remember the a student class dot, it has method called get number of students, right? If you remember this a student class, which I covered in very details, I've explained you everything in the student class. So when you say get list of students, basically it will give you a list which has list of a student object, nothing else, right? A student is the class which has name and age. So now just focus here, try to remember this method, okay? Because I'll be using that very often. On this if I call, since the return type is the list, so I can call a stream here, right? Dot, I can call filter. So in filter it takes a predicate. So what is the return type till here, when I will just call number of students dot stream, the return type is going to be a stream of a student, right? A stream of students. So when I'll write a predicate, you know, one by one the student will be supplied here. So I can write here a student dot, sorry, xx dot get age. I can write here on filter if it is greater than 20, right? So this is my filter, right? So I am saying that get the age if age is greater than 20. What happened to this filter? Why it is complaining? It is saying that syntax error, token is misplaced constructor. What is this? Why can't I write like this? If a is greater than 20, right, dot count. Okay, I don't know, it was complaining, but there is no problem. So I can count, right? So I can just write inside the print statement, and this will work fine. I can run that. So you can see that our count is 3. Okay, so you can see that like this filter is very, very important. It will help you a lot when you want to write some filter. It will help you a lot when you write a filter. With this, I'll close the filter method in the stream, and in my next video, I'll start with some new methods. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this.